Since the rise of social media influencers, society has seen countless bloggers progress successfully, captivating viewers with daily posts and building a following of thousands. This film, which supports my written dissertation, gives viewers an insight into the life of a social media influencer and the life of everyday people influenced by them.
What do I think makes an influencer? I think you've just got to have something about you. Like, there's so many people in their bios now like, oh, I'm a blogger. Like I said, I don't refer to myself as a blogger. I hate that word because as much as I do write some blogs, I don't. Being an influencer is very wide. There's a very wide ratio in being an influencer these days. I think there's too many people doing it, but I don't really know how to define it because everyone's got their own things that they do, I suppose. Hard to answer.
I would define a social media influencer as someone who is quite approachable. So the people who you have on Instagram who, you know, only buy designer handbags and only buy designer clothes, I might follow them for a little bit of inspiration, but I probably don't engage with them as much. So I think they've got to be down to earth, quite approachable and quite likeable. I like it when they're funny. They make funny jokes and things like that. And stylish, I suppose. I do have social media. I'm most influenced by Instagram, without a shadow of doubt. But I also have Facebook and don't use Twitter and use LinkedIn for work.
I use Facebook and I have Instagram I use. But it doesn't influence my fashion. My style is something that I take from within and something that when I find stuff I like, I will just go for it and put it together my way.
I don't get inspiration, I just wear the things that I like, and I've been doing that for years. My dad's a very well-dressed man, he's always in a three-piece suit, top hat, that sort of vibe. So I've always been dressed amicably since then.
For some, it may be someone within their personal lives who they look up to, but for others, social media is a lead influence in their fashion choices, as they feel just as connected to a blogger as they do a family member.
Why do I do influencing? I know it sounds a bit funny, and a lot of people ask me how I got into it, but I did actually just fall into it. I'm going to be a blogger and bought this mirror, decorated this room and did it. It was a long process. Yes, I do feel capable of influencing others because I feel like a lot of girls trust me when it comes to my fashion, and I feel like I only promote people that I feel like are actually genuinely worth promoting. I wouldn't promote someone if I didn't think they were good, if that makes sense. I don't like to false advertise, that's what it is. So yeah, I do think I'm good at influencing because I'm honest, and I feel like you have to be honest in this game.
I do think it's got a little bit out of hand. Bloggers have got a little bit out of hand. They're taking themselves too serious. It's becoming too organized. It is just replacing the old fashioned press. And being just as judgmental as they were.
Instagram, social media doesn't influence my style choice whatsoever. I work in fashion and I don't give a shit about Instagram or social media in any shape or form, as I think it's taken over the fashion world and it's not a good thing. Fuck Instagram.
Despite some having a negative opinion of social media influencers, they still feel the pressure to be part of their world. Many people use social media to their advantage, benefiting from influencers' tips and tricks to stay on trend. It's just as easy as clicking and swiping to find where to get their inspiration.
So one of my favorite bloggers, let's say, would be this one. And today's look, it was inspired by this girl. I'm inspired because I really like her style, and I'm looking to bring something fresh all the time, so this is what she's doing.
There's two stylists that I follow called Belle and Bunty, and they've done Swipe to Shop. These boots are something that I used on Swipe to Shop. They're on from Jones the Bootmaker, and that was on their Instagram stories about 2 weeks ago, and I swiped click for.
With the new Swipe to Shop feature on Instagram, followers can now easily access the same item worn by influencers, making it quick and easy for brands to sell products, proving that the connection between the brands and the consumer is now social media influencers.
Do I feel subject to social media? Yes, I do feel subject to it in terms of the fact that people want you for and don't want to pay you for what you're worth. But at the same time, I am 9 times out of 10 also benefiting from it because I am getting more and more out there and meeting more people. So yeah, again, it's a bit of a yes no answer.
But does this subtle use of marketing affect our identity as the consumer?
I think my identity is based on me, it's not influenced by anyone.
I do think that social media bloggers do affect, not affect, yeah, no, affect our identity, not to the extent of, I still remain who I am, but I'm still very much influenced by what they select and what they are, what is on trend. And I'm possibly, I used to be someone who read a lot of magazines. I probably read less magazines now because I'm now getting that influence from Instagram.
So the question now stands, are magazines a thing of yesterday? Is it time we gave up the Vogue covers and focused on the future of online influencing only?
I'd say I get influenced by a lot of magazines. So I grew up kind of reading Vogue and like Harper's Bazaar and flicking through all those kind of things, and like magazines like Numero, ID, Dazed, like a lot of kind of my influence at the moment.
I got my fashion influence from reading fashion magazines. Yeah, I've always been influenced by fashion magazines and also watching celebrities on television, seeing what they're wearing.
Celebrities now use Instagram to promote their fashion identity. What used to be airbrushing in magazines is now in the form of Instagram filters and editing apps.
Am I guilty of using editing apps? If you was to get hold of my phone, I literally have a folder for photography full of editing apps. Like a folder full of them. I do edit my pictures, but not to the extreme that some people go to where you literally can't recognise them. I feel like this is a hard question because I don't want people to get the wrong impression of me from it, if that makes any sense. So yes, I do feel responsible, but no, I don't, because they don't know me, if that makes sense. Like until you know me, you don't understand how I like to put things across. If I could go back 5 years, would I tell myself to be an influencer? I don't know, because I want to say it's easy, because it is easy, but it's not at the same time. Like, anyone that knows me knows that my life is constant. I don't regret it. I don't want to say I regret it, because I do really enjoy it. I feel like if I would have started influencing a lot earlier, like a few of the girls on Instagram that have 600,000-800,000 following, if I would have started earlier, I would have been bigger by now. Working in an environment where you're constantly with people is very good for the soul. And I feel like when I sit here on my own, like, I always think about my Christmas party. Who's going to come to my Christmas party? Just me. So in terms of that, I wouldn't recommend it, because I don't think it's healthy to work on your own. But then I know you're obviously all going to be thinking, oh, all these events and all of that, but they're not my work colleagues. I don't see them all day to day. It's like a social thing for me. I'm just networking with people because I have to at the end of the day, because I need people to know who I am. So would I recommend it? No. I don't want to say no, because I know there's so many people that are trying to do it. But maybe go a different way about it. And if I could turn back 5 years, I probably wouldn't have become an influencer, no.
From my findings, some opinions of social media influencers believe that they do indeed have a detrimental effect on our identities, poisoning our minds with an unattainable goal. To contrast, countless followers see social media influencers as positive role models who not only look good, but possess traits that many aspire to. For the life of an influencer, having a following of thousands is a constant boost to their egos, but after exploring the realities of being an influencer, is the lifestyle as attractive as they would have us believe?